Hi, thanks for joining me. This is Angie at Chicken Scratch, and this is the project we're making today. Okay, so this is week 4 of the 12 weeks of Halloween, and I'm super excited to show you this project. It actually holds a little snack-sized bag of candy. You can use gummy bears, M&Ms, Reese's Pieces, bottle caps, any of those little bags of candy that you can buy this time of year. The stamp set that we're using is Sweet Hauntings. Isn't it awesome? And the designer series paper is Happy Haunting. It's on page 47 of the holiday catalog. I'm so happy we can show this to you now. Okay, so we are going to be making all three of these. They're super easy to make, and you can make a ton of them for Halloween. So I'm going to slide them out of the way, get the designer series paper, got the Simply Scored scoring tool. The DSP is cut at 8.5 by 2.75. I'm going to go ahead and score all three of them now. Now, before I do this, don't forget, head over to my website, leave a comment to enter to win. This kit to make all three of these will be going out to someone, and I'll announce the winner when I post week 5, okay? I don't know why I said that so fast, but anyway, I think it's because Skittles behind me is being very vocal. Again, 8.5, 2.75. I'm going to score it at 1/2 inch, 3.75, 4.75, and 8. So I'm going to do this on all three pieces. 1/2 inch, 3.75, 4.75, and 8. And then the last one, 1/2 inch, 3.75, 4.75, and 8. Okay, so we're done with this one. Now we're going to fold this piece back and then the other score lines forward and then this one back as well. Okay, so it's going to work just like that. Okay. You can give that a little squeeze. So you're going to actually staple your candy right in there if you want to, so it doesn't fall out. So this piece is going to fold forward and fold this over. Well, it looks like my score lines weren't real straight. Okay, now that one. And the last one to fold. Okay, so now these are ready. We'll set these aside for now because we're actually going to be stapling our image on there, okay? Now I've got three pieces of paper in here. You could just use one piece, one long piece. I just jumped ahead. So the first one we're going to use is the, we're going to make this one first because first I inked it in Tangelo Twist. And then I added some black stays on top. Okay, so I'm going to get the Happy, Happy Halloween and add the ink. And then now I'm just going to put some black stays on the edges. And stamp. And there's that one. So now I'm going to clean my image. So I've got my Stampin' Mist and pad here. So I'm going to clean that. Now it's ready to stamp in the just the black ink. So this is basic black. We can officially order it now out of the holiday catalog. Yay. I love it. And then the next image, we're going to use basic gray. This is also in the holiday catalog. I'm looking at them. They both kind of look the same. There we go. Okay, so now we're going to take our note tag punch. I love this punch. Don't I say that about everything that we have, though? Sorry about that. I really do love all this stuff. Okay, so there's that one. And then this one. And our final one. So the person that gets the kit, they're going to have plenty of room because you could just turn this over, make another one, and cut it right out, okay? We're using our vanilla thick baker's twine. And I was about to say I love it, so I won't do that to you again. Okay, so I'm going to add the candy right here. So whatever snack size candy you want to add, you just add it there. Bring it to the top. Take your image, and you can angle it or place it on there straight, however you want. And you're going to take our handy dandy stapler, which I'm going to say I love because I do. So there it is. See how easy? You can make a ton of them. Now, for this one, I'm going to be honest. I had someone ask me how to make the little treats in the little box in the catalog, and I said, well, I don't know, but I can figure it out. So I didn't actually make that exact box in the catalog, but I decorated these exactly like the box. So any of the boxes that I've shown on my website can be made using this stamp set and these images. Okay, I'm going to trim it. Now for these, we left the twine a little bit longer. Now, I decided I was going to change it up a bit. Let me staple this. Now this is minus the candy. And instead of taking it to the side, what I did was I just added a little bow at the top. And I placed it, I've stapled this without the, greeting or the image. No one will know. We'll pretend I didn't do that. Okay, so I'm just going to make a little bow. So it might be easier for you to just tie a little bow with the twine and then add it with a glue dot. I'll make sure the next time I film a video that Skittles over there, we call her Sneaky Beaky. Well, I actually call her lots of names. She's quite funny. Miss Bella's over here too. She just doesn't make as much noise, thank goodness. Okay, so this goes right there at the top. Okay, so there's the second one. And I'm going to do the same thing to this one. So I'm just going to staple it right up here at the top. Maybe this one will straighten it a little bit since it's got stripes. And then we'll tie a bow. And then add it with a glue dot. So this is one of those projects that you can make for your child's classroom or your grandchild, because you can make a bunch of them out of one sheet of paper. Okay, so this wraps up this project. If you would like to place an order to get any of this product, head over to my Chicken Scratch blog. Have a great day. Thanks a lot. Bye.